Okay, friends, good afternoon. We'll start this topic, capital budgeting. I think some of you might have studied it earlier. Thoda bahut hum pad chuke hain na pehle?
Yes, sir.
But still, we'll start it afresh. So we'll quickly recapitulate some of the issues. Then we'll enter into the new areas. Capital budgeting, you know, this is a part of investment decision. And you know, in financial management, so we learn about three kinds of decisions. Is it not? Can you tell me what are these three kinds of decisions? Just like one is investment decision, then
dividend decision
and
financing decision.
Okay, investment decision, dividend decisions, and financing decision. And these capital budgeting decisions are a category of investment decisions. Okay, and this is very important decision. We have already studied earlier the meaning of capital budgeting. In the meaning of capital budgeting, there will be several kind of investment possibilities, and we have to take a decision where to make investment. And each possibilities or each investment proposal needs to be evaluated, and by applying certain models, we'll select a particular investment decision. We'll decide on that. Okay, suppose we have to decide whether we'll make investment in plant A or plant B, or whether we'll make investment in business A or business B, whether we'll go for steel plant or aluminium plant. So like this, several options we have to select. Okay, this is called as investment decision. So this is a process of evaluating and selecting long-term investments. Okay, so this is basically long-term investment decision. Just like I ask often that suppose you put petrol in your bike, is it? Can we call it as a capital budgeting decision?
No,
it's not a capital budgeting decision because it is a kind of routine decision every time you do. But suppose you buy a bike, you are planning to buy a bike. Is it a capital budgeting decision?
Yes,
because it represents a huge outlay of money. Is it? And we will make investment at particular point of time. That means today, suppose we are making investment, but we will be getting benefits in future. Is it not? Investment made today, but benefits will be receiving in future. Okay. And we have to be very careful in making this kind of investment. Because once we invest money in a particular decision, then we have to bear its consequences throughout the life of these assets. Is it not? अगर एक गलत गाड़ी हमने खरीद लिया तो गाड़ी का जितनी लाइफ है हम लोग को तब तक तो झेलना पड़ेगा उसको, राइट? वी हैव टू बियर इट्स कंसीक्वेंसेस. सो देयरफॉर यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेन सिलेक्टिंग दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस. ओके, एंड दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस आर कॉल्ड एज कैपिटल बजटिंग डिसीजंस. एंड हियर मनी इज इन्वेस्टेड इन अ काइंड ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट्स और अ काइंड ऑफ नॉन करंट एसेट्स. मनी हैज टू बी इन्वेस्टेड टुडे. ओके, but benefits has to be received, benefits has to be obtained in future, and benefits are not known with certainty. That means how much benefit you will get, you are not sure at the initial stage. You are not sure that what will be the value of this, but investment has to be met. Okay, so therefore when I am making investment today, but benefit has to be received in future, so I have to compare this investment amount, that is which is my cost, with the benefits, and benefits are not certain. Because of this thing, because benefits are risky, benefits are uncertain, but investment has to be made today. So these are quite complex decisions, right? Investment decisions are complex decision, or capital budgeting decisions are complex, complex decisions. So one by one, we will be learning various techniques how to take decisions in a capital budgeting scenario. Okay, is it audible? Clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Why it is important? You might be knowing, but still we'll repeat it quickly, very quickly. Why capital budgeting is dividend? Can you is important? Can you read these points? First point, try to read.
Substantial expenditure.
Substantial expenditure. First of all, that means huge amount of money is involved. Is it not? Okay. Suppose you want to buy a bike. You want to buy a scooty, so money involved is huge. Therefore, it is important. So you cannot just like that. You cannot spend a huge amount. Okay. Now, what is the second point? Point two, irreversible decision. That means once you have taken a decision, it cannot be reversed. Suppose you take a decision to buy a wrong scooter, which is not suitable to your requirement. Then, if you want to sell it immediately, then you have to do it at a substantial amount of loss. Therefore, these decisions are irreversible. ऐसा नहीं कि आज आप बोलेंगे मैं स्टील प्लांट बनाऊंगा, छह महीने के बाद बोलेंगे नहीं स्टील नहीं एल्यूमिनियम बनाते हैं. ऐसे कर पाएंगे क्या? So therefore, these decisions are irreversible. Third point, why it is important is that, what is third point? Please read.
Complex.
Complex. Why it is complex? Because money has to be spent today, cost has to be incurred today, but benefit has to be received in future. Money has to be spent today, benefits have to be received in future. Therefore, it is complex. Okay. And fourth point is that, read it, what is fourth point?
Effect over long term, long period of time.
So the consequence of this decision, once you are taking a decision, the effect will be continuing in long term. That means today, suppose you are buying a scooter, you have to bear, let us say for coming 5-6 years or coming 10 years, you have to bear with that. So therefore, because of these issues, capital budgeting decisions are important. Okay, I will be sending you the slides. Don't worry about the slides, but try to learn it. Okay, slides will be sent to you immediately after the class. Okay, but in case you have any problem, if you are not understanding something, please raise your voice. Okay, आपका speaker on mute रखिए. अगर वो mute है नीचे देखिए उसको on mute कीजिए, so that you can ask questions. ठीक है? कहीं भी आपको doubt हो, कुछ भी जरूरत हो, आप question पूछ सकते हैं. ठीक है? And capital budgeting process involves several steps. Okay, this is, can you read the what is written in the slide? Capital budgeting process. First one is
planning.
Second,
evaluation.
Third,
selection.
Fourth,
implementation.
Five,
control.
Six,
review.
Okay, now I am explaining you how exactly capital budgeting process happens. First, we plan. Plan means we find out what are the potential opportunity. Kya kya possibilities hai? Suppose you want to buy a scooty. There are several options. Company A, company B, company C. Different models are there. So you have to decide. You have to find out these are the potential opportunity. Matlab, these are the areas where we can make investment. Then next step is that we have to evaluate which is better, which is not better. We have to evaluate what is the cost, what is the benefit, all these things you have to evaluate for each of these options. Okay. Third thing is that we have to take, we have to do a selection. उसमें कौन सा select करेंगे? Decide करेंगे. Okay, I will go for this particular scooty. Suppose I am planning to go for TVS Jupiter or particular company scooter. So that is about the selection. So first you plan, then evaluate it, then select it. Okay. Then after selecting, you have to implement that decision. Meaning you will purchase that asset and you will use it. Right? That is implementation. After implementation, then you have to do some control exercise. You have to see that what you have planned, actually it is happening in that way or not. That is control. Suppose you had planned something. So you have planned for a business. You thought first 6 months sales will be like this. But actually sale is happening or not. You need to know. That is control. Then finally, once the project is over, then you have to review the entire process. आपने क्या सोचा था, finally क्या हुआ, entire project. Okay, so this is called as the capital budgeting process. Just have a brief understanding, you need not remember this thing. Okay, so planning, then evaluation, then selection, then implementation, then control throughout the life of the project. Then once the project is over, then you have to do the review. Okay. आपके लिए एक रिपीटेशन हो जाएगा कि सम ऑफ यू मे नॉट बी देयर, बट क्विकली उसको कवर कर लेंगे, फिर आप एयर एयर के बाद शुरू करेंगे. ठीक है? सो क्विकली एक लेट अस हैव अ ग्लांस, देन एनपीवी से शुरू होगा. ओके आज कोशिश करते हैं क्विकली कवर करने के लिए. अगर कुछ सिस्टम में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है तो आइडेंटिफाई हो जाएगा आज. ओके ये चीज आपको पता है. वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजन ये भी पहले डिस्कस हो चुका था. ठीक है रिप्लेसमेंट डिसीजन मॉडर्नाइजेशन डिसीजन एक्सपांशन डिसीजन. रिप्लेसमेंट डिसीजन मॉडर्नाइजेशन डिसीजन मीन्स एक एसेट है इसको आप हटा के दूसरा एसेट लाओ. ठीक है दैट इज रिप्लेसमेंट डिसीजन. एक्सपांशन डिसीजन मीन्स वो एसेट को नहीं हटाओगे पर एक नया एसेट उसके साथ ऐड कर रहे हो. दैट इज एक्सपांशन डिसीजन. ठीक है डाइवर्सिफिकेशन मीन्स you are changing, you are from one line of business you are moving to multiple line of business. ठीक है is it audible clear?
Yes sir.
अच्छा अगर किसी का भी background से कुछ noise आ रहा है तो आप वो सिर्फ speaker mute कर दीजिए. अगर किसी का अगर हो रहा है ठीक है किसी का background से noise आ रहा है क्या मतलब अगर background से noise आ रहा है तो mute your speaker so that बाकी लोग disturb नहीं होंगे. ठीक है अच्छा ठीक है अगर नहीं नॉइज नहीं आ रहा है तो स्पीकर ऑन रखिए आप बात कर सकते. अगर ये स्पीकर को आप म्यूट कर लेंगे तो आपका बात मैं सुन नहीं पाऊंगा. मेरा बात आप सुन लेंगे कोई दिक्कत नहीं होगा. अगर बैकग्राउंड क्लियर है बैकग्राउंड में कोई नॉइज नहीं है तो स्पीकर ऑन रखिए. अगर बैकग्राउंड में कुछ नॉइज है तो उसको आप कर दीजिए. ठीक है सो अगेन वी कैन हैव ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डिसीजन सिचुएशन वी कैन हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ investment decision, mutually exclusive decision, accept reject decisions, contingent and dependable decision. All these kinds of decisions we have discussed earlier also. Okay, you have any query? Mutually exclusive matlab ek kaam karenge to dusra nahi kar sakte. Accept reject decisions means only ek hi option hai. Either you have to accept or reject this. Contingent decision means it depends upon some other decision. Matlab wahan ek factory banayenge to ab ek connected road bhi banana padega. रोड बनाना इज ए कंटिजेंट डिसीजन. ठीक है सो दीज आर द वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ डिसीजन. यू हैव सम आइडिया आप कुछ समझ में आ रहा है इसके बारे में?
यस सर.
ओके सो नाउ वी विल मूव. ओके एंड इन दिस कैपिटल बजटिंग डिसीजंस सो टू थिंग्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट. वन इज लाइफ ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट सेकेंड वन इज कैश फ्लो. द लाइफ ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट डिपेंड्स अपॉन टेक्नोलॉजी depends upon physical deterioration depends upon the demand of the output of the project. Okay so life may vary life may be extended because of all these things but once we know the life suppose you are buying a bike you should know what is the life. Life is 5 years 10 years if technology changes life will be changed life of the asset will be affected. Okay or maybe technology is there but physically asset may got deteriorated maybe over 10 years और डिक्लाइन द आउटपुट. यू आर प्रोड्यूसिंग समथिंग उसका आउटपुट का अगर डिमांड नहीं रहेगा तब भी आपका प्रोजेक्ट खत्म हो जाएगा. ठीक है सो लाइफ ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट डिपेंड्स अपॉन ऑल दिस थिंग टेक्नोलॉजिकल ऑब्सोलेसेंस फिजिकल डिटोरिएशन देन डिक्लाइन इन डिमांड. ओके ठीक है एंड कैश फ्लो डिपेंड्स अपॉन द इनिशियल कैश आउटफ्लो इंटरिम और इंक्रीमेंटल कैश फ्लो एंड टर्मिनल कैश फ्लो. इनिशियली कितने आप इन्वेस्ट करेंगे वो आपका आउटफ्लो है खर्चा है. इन बिटवीन क्या क्या आपको प्रॉफिट मिल रहा है दैट इज इंटरिम कैश फ्लो एंड फाइनली जब प्रोजेक्ट को बेच देंगे जब खत्म हो जाएगा प्रोजेक्ट क्लोज करेंगे क्या कैश फ्लो मिलेगा. ओके दीज आर द थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ कैश फ्लो.
सर पॉइंट सर पॉइंट 2 थोड़ा और एक बार समझा सकते
पहले जो लाइफ. ठीक है पहले जो लाइफ में 3 पॉइंट था. ओके उसके बाद
कैश फ्लो cash flow second point interim incremental cash flow.
Okay cash flow second point you are asking right. You see cash flow suppose aap dekho aap ko ek business shuru karoge. Okay suppose you want to start a garment shop aapko abhi 10 lakh rupaye bhi kharcha karna padega. Ye jo 10 lakh rupaye aap initially kharcha karoge wo hai aapka initial outflow. Pehle paisa jayega aapka pocket se that is initial outflow. Theek hai theek hai but let us say yes, every year you are earning 2 lakh rupees that is your interim cash flow. 2 lakh rupees earn kar rahe matlab aap ho sakta hai aap 10 lakh rupees kharcha ho raha hai 10 lakh rupees sell ho raha hai 8 lakh rupees aapka kharcha hai baki 2 lakh rupees aapka profit hai har saal aise suppose 2 lakh ho raha hai wo aapka interim. Interim means project ke shuru aur end se beech mein jo cash flow aa raha hai that is your interim cash flow.
That is annuity also.
No, not necessarily annuity. It may be annuity in some cases, but real business में तो annuity नहीं है ना. रियल बिजनेस में वो वेरी करता है, कभी दो लाख हुआ, कभी तीन लाख हुआ, कभी एक लाख हुआ, कभी पचास हजार हुआ, सब वेरी करेगा अनइवन कैश फ्लो. ठीक है, टर्मिनल कैश फ्लो सपोज 10 साल के बाद आपने प्रोजेक्ट क्लोज कर दिया, तो दुकान बेच दिया, तो आपको जो मिलेगा दैट इज योर टर्मिनल कैश फ्लो. ठीक है, हम कैपिटल बजटिंग का डिसीजन लेंगे, मतलब ये सारी कैश फ्लो को आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे हर सिचुएशन में, इनिशियल कितनी, इंटरिम कितनी, टर्मिनल कितनी, ऑन दैट बेसिस विल टेक डिसीजन. ठीक है, ओके ओके. बेसिक प्रिंसिपल आई विल नॉट टेल यू, एंड दिस इज, यू सी, दीज आर वेरियस काइंड्स ऑफ टेक्निक्स टू इवैल्यूएट कैश फ्लोस. ठीक है, इन कैपिटल बजटिंग वी नीड टू इवैल्यूएट द कैश फ्लोस, इवैल्यूएट द डिसीजन. You see, broadly there are two categories of decision. One is non-discounted or traditional method. Are you able to read?
Yes, sir.
And the second part, what is written here?
Discounted or time-adjusted.
Time-adjusted method. Okay. Non-discounted method में दो method है, payback period method and ARR method. ठीक है? And both the methods we had covered earlier, payback and ARR. ठीक है? पहले हम पढ़ चुके
हैं. यस सर.
ओके, पेबैक पीरियड मेथड, एआरआर मेथड वी हैव कवर्ड. एंड डिस्काउंटेड और टाइम एडजस्टेड मेथड मींस हियर वी कंसीडर द टाइम वैल्यू ऑफ मनी, राइट? ओके, एंड देयर डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो मेथड और डिस्काउंटेड पेबैक पीरियड मेथड, नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू मेथड, आईआरआर मेथड एंड वन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दिस मॉडिफाइड आईआरआर मेथड. And one is benefit cost ratio or profitability index method. These kind of methods are there. Okay. Just have an understanding. No need to copy right now. Slides will be given to you. ठीक है, समझ में आ रहा है ये सारी method को?
Yes sir.
अब बोलो discounted method में क्या क्या है?
DCF और DPV, NPV method, IRR method, modified IRR method, BCR or profitability index method.
Good. So all these methods will be covering, but quickly this payback period ARR method, which some of you might have already learned, but still we'll repeat it. Okay, for the benefit of other students who are not there in the class, we'll be repeating it. Okay. But before coming to this discounted or time adjusted method, we need to understand the concept of time value of money. The time value of money, we have already learned it separately, but in the concept of time value of money, you have remembered that concept. Time value of money, there is a separate chapter also in the study material. The concept of time value of money says that rupee 1 today is not equal to rupee 1 tomorrow. You have understood it earlier, is it not? Okay?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Why rupee 1 today is not equal to rupee 1 tomorrow? Because these reasons. First of all, inflation. Because of inflation, value of money diminishes. Is it not? Yes. Secondly, postponement of consumption. Suppose मैं आपको अभी दूं एक रुपया, you can use it. अगर अभी नहीं दूं, एक साल का बाद दूंगा, तो you will be postponing your consumption. तो इसके लिए आपको कुछ compensation चाहिए. वो ही है time value of money. Time value of money is the compensation for all these things. Compensation for inflation, compensation for postponement of consumption, and compensation for opportunity of use. अगर पैसा आपको अभी मिलता तो आप use करते, लेकिन आपको अभी आपको पैसा नहीं मिलेगा तो अभी आप use नहीं करोगे. Therefore, you want a kind of compensation. Fourth thing is that risk. So if money will be received in future, it will involve some amount of risk. Who knows that in future you'll be receiving money or not? It comes to you in the form of a promise, but nobody knows, so actually you will be receiving money or not. Therefore, you want a compensation for this thing. Compensation for inflation, compensation for postponement of consumption, compensation for opportunity of use, and compensation for risk. All these compensations taken together, we call it as the time value of money. So time value of money is the compensation that is required for all these things. Okay. So in earlier classes, I had told you basic formula how to compute time value of money. Basically, It is the RI plus RF plus what is this?
RP.
RP. That means rate of inflation. Then real rate of return from risk-free investment. Then RP is
risk-free.
Acha, you tell me. Suppose inflation is 5%. Okay. And risk-free rate of return is 4%. And risk premium is 2%. Okay. Yes, tell me, what is time value of money? Understood?
That is 11%?
Yeah. What you did? You have to add up all these three things.
Yes, sir.
Okay, all three things taken together is the time value of money. So that is how we can compute time value. Once we know the time value of money, the advantage is that we can move from present value to future value. Okay. You know what is present value, what is future value? Present value is the today's value of tomorrow's money. Kal aapko jo milne wala hai, suppose kal aapko sab ek saal ke baad aapko 100 rupaye milne wala hai. Uska present value kya hai? That is PV or present value. और आज का 100 रुपया एक साल के बाद उसका वैल्यू क्या होगा, वो फ्यूचर वैल्यू। ठीक है, पता है तो आपको? यस सर। नो,
यस सर।
प्रेजेंट वैल्यू फ्यूचर वैल्यू, यू नो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू फ्यूचर वैल्यू, आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू अर्लियर आल्सो। ओके, द प्रोसेस ऑफ मूविंग फ्रॉम प्रेजेंट वैल्यू टू फ्यूचर वैल्यू इज कॉल्ड एज
कंपाउंडिंग।
कंपाउंडिंग एंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ मूविंग फ्रॉम फ्यूचर वैल्यू टू प्रेजेंट वैल्यू इज कॉल्ड एज
discounting.
So sometimes we might have to discount, sometimes we might have to
compound.
Okay, depends whether we want to move from present value to future value or from future value to present value. We have to compound and we have to discount. And I had explained you earlier how to do it. Okay.
Yes,
now, quickly I'll be showing you these tables. I had all these tables also. You know, this is the future value table of a single sum. Okay, is it visible? Suppose,
yes,
you see, suppose for 8 years at 10%, okay, you want to find out the future value of some money, then we have to multiply with this factor. What is this factor?
Future value factor.
2.144. Okay, this is the future value of a single sum. Similarly, you know there is a future value for, there is a present value for single sum. One more table is there. The table sorry, आपको आज स्लाइड में मिल जाएगी. ये आपको दिखाई दे रहा है? Are you able to read?
Yes, sir.
दिख रहा है आपका स्क्रीन पे?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, there is future value of an ordinary annuity. One more table. One more table is there for present value of an ordinary annuity. By referring to these tables, we can move from present value to future value. Okay, understood? This is the concept of time value. So we can move from present value to future value by multiplying with these factors. Yeah, any query you have?
No, sir.
Okay. Up to this, we have already learned from the class. So I think that's, therefore I am moving a little fast. Okay. Once I have understood, first we will cover these techniques. First technique is, let us say, payback period. Payback period we have already covered. All of you have learned it.
Yes, sir.
But the meaning we have discussed, payback period. Okay, I think one example also we had done. This is the example, how to compute payback period.
Initial cash flow by annuity cash flow.
Yeah, ye class hum class mein kiye the na?
Yes, sir.
अच्छा, ये और दोबारा करने का जरूरत है? यस और नो? दोबारा करेंगे क्या?
सर, मैं तो कर चुकी हूँ।
अच्छा, क्या करेंगे उसको फिर दोबारा? आप तो कर चुके हो, क्योंकि बाकी जिसको चाहिए आप लोग बोलो, आपको चाहिए क्या दोबारा करने पेबैक पीरियड में?
यस सर। Yes, sir.
करेंगे, अच्छा।
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, so we'll quickly see this payback period method. ओके इन बिटवीन आपको एक चीज बोल देता हूँ. सो आज ये पुराना जो कोर्स है जितने हम पढ़ चुके थे पे बैक पीरियड मेथड और क्या पढ़ाते थे ARR, ये दोनों आज कंप्लीट कर लेंगे. बट देखो ये क्या होगा, अभी मे बी अनदर 5 मिनट्स में ये वीडियो ऑटोमेटिकली ऑफ हो जाएगा क्योंकि 40 मिनट का स्लॉट था. तो अगर ऑफ हो जाएगा तो आप लोग बैठे रहिए, मैं फिर दोबारा आपको भेजूंगा एक आईडी, ठीक है, दोबारा यू विल बी लॉगिंग. तो आज पुराना जितने भी पढ़ चुके हैं उसको कंप्लीट कर सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्लास अगेन वी विल बी हैविंग ए क्लास टुमारो एट 3:30, देन वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम एनपीवी, ठीक है. आज क्विकली मैं पर्पसफुली इसको कवर कर रहा हूँ, आसानी से ये हो जाएगा, ठीक है. कल 3:30 को फिर एग्जैक्टली आप आ जाइए, सेमिनार में विल बी कवरिंग. अच्छा ये कभी भी वीडियो अभी ऑफ हो सकता है, लेकिन बैठे रहिए मैं दोबारा फिर आपको आईडी भेजूंगा. नाउ लेट अस सी दिस पे बैक पीरियड. पे बैक पीरियड मींस इफ इनिशियली आई एम मेकिंग सम इन्वेस्टमेंट, वो कितनी दिन में हम लोग को रिकवर हो जाएगा. ओके इन हाउ मेनी डेज प्रोजेक्ट विल बी पेइंग मी बैक, ठीक है. सपोज आप 1 लाख रुपए अभी इन्वेस्टमेंट किए हो, आप सोचो यू टेक एन एग्जांपल, लेट अस से यू हैव इन्वेस्टेड 1 लाख रुपीज नाउ. Okay, and let us say every year it is giving you 10,000 rupees. ठीक है, समझ में आ रहा है? तो आपको कितनी साल लगेगा 1 लाख रुपए रिकवर करने के लिए?
10 साल.
10 साल. कैसे आपको पता चला?
Total outflow by inflow.
Total outflow. Total outflow is 1 lakh divided by
inflow. Annuity inflow.
Annuity inflow. क्योंकि हर साल क्या हुआ था, सिमिलर अमाउंट सेम अमाउंट एक एनुइटी तरह आपको मिल रहा था, आपने स्ट्रेट पे डिवाइड कर लिया कि मैंने 1 लाख रुपए इन्वेस्ट किया हूँ, हर साल 10 लाख रुपए मेरा रिकवर, 10,000 रुपए रिकवर हो रहा है, तो मेरे को मिलेगा क्या, मेरे को आराम से मिलेगा 10 साल में पूरा अमाउंट. सो इफ द कैश फ्लो इज एन एनुइटी देन पे बैक पीरियड इज इनिशियल आउटफ्लो डिवाइडेड बाय एनुइटी इनफ्लो, राइट. आर यू सीइंग द व्हाइट बोर्ड?
यस
सर. दिख रहा है आपको? ओके सपोज ये आपको पढ़ रहा है, दिखाई दे रहा है? क्या लिखा मैंने? क्या दिखाई नहीं दे रहा?
नहीं सर,
दिखाई नहीं.
10,000 लिखा.
अच्छा अच्छा ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं, ठीक है, कोई बात नहीं, विल डू वन थिंग.